I want to welcome everyone who's joined us for our little science demonstration entitled Merging with Christ. And I need to open up the slide presentation here for those in the classroom. We'll go to page 2. Abide in me and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself except it abide in the vine, no more can ye except ye abide in me. John 15:4. Slide 3 is a beautiful picture of some grapes on the vine. Every year we hope to do this in our garden, have grapes on the vine. We have grapevines, but not as many grapes as you see on slide 4. Now, the items you need for this particular science demonstration are very few. And you can do it at home right now with me, although it takes a little getting used to, and it took me a little while. But all you need is a clear plastic water bottle. This happens to be a soda bottle. I tried water bottles. They're kind of flimsy, and it was hard for me to get it to work. So this is harder plastic. And the slide number 5 says you need a sharp pencil. That didn't work for me because it just didn't work. So I used the sharp edge of a screw. And you just push it into the plastic enough to go up one revolution on the screw. And into the plastic near the bottom, you need to poke 2. I was going to use 2, but the directions said 3, and it didn't work with 2. So I did 3 in case the pressure wasn't quite right. So you poke 3 holes side by side, or 2. 2 really will work, near the bottom of your plastic bottle. And they should be about 1/4 inch apart. So I've already done that. No, we don't need the lid, actually. And then what we're going to do is pour water in this bottle, fill it up, and what you're going to see will be 3 streams of water, of course, coming out of those 3 holes. But the title of our science demonstration is Merging with Christ. Now, if you look at slide 6, it tells you just what I've told you, to fill the bottle with water, which is what we're going to do. So we're going to move over here. We need this tub, and Ashley, I'm going to need your help, because I know you're going to want to do this, but you watch for the first time around. And so we're going to put water in this, and maybe we should say a little mental prayer that this works out. So we just want to fill it faster than it goes out, and you'll see water coming on the other side. That was the first trial that didn't work. Okay, now, you see here? Can you see see those 3 streams? Now we're going to merge them with our finger and thumb. There's 2 have merged. Whoops. See how 2 have merged? Do you see that, Ashley? Those 2 on the hook?
Now we're all merged.
Now this one is coming down. Let's see if I can get it.
Could we rotate the whole thing toward the camera?
Okay. I've got 2 merged. Okay, this is called a water knot. And if you can see, those 2 streams have merged into 1. Last evening when I was doing this, I got all 3 to merge into a water knot.
You had them all 3 merged.
Okay, now we're going to put more water in because there's a step I want to show you. After you get it merged, you can run your finger over the holes, and that will open up the streams again, so to speak, so that you get 3 individual streams. And then you try to merge again. So I'm going to let Ashley do this.
Can I pour the water in?
Sure, you can pour the water in. Junior scientist wants to do all these things, huh? Just, you have to pour it in as best you can. Tip it up just a tad. There, you've got 1 water knot. Tip it a little bit further. There, she got 3. 3 merged into a water knot. Can you see that, Pastor?
Yes.
Okay. All right, now open them up. Run your finger across.
There you go.
And you see, now we have 3 streams again. See if you can merge them again. Very good. You got two moves. Three. Very good. Nice, Ashley. Okay. Now, there's a reason why I'm showing you this. Because we want our lives abiding in Christ. We want to merge, so to speak, with Christ. We don't want to be on individual paths, maybe even going side by side. And so, when we surrender our ways to Jesus, surrender our will to Jesus, we're going to talk about being sanctified, or what sanctification or to sanctify means later in our lesson. But that's what's happening. We are surrendering our wills to Jesus. And our he merges, he lives within us, and our lives merge with him. However, we can change our minds, and we can go our individual ways, which is what we saw when we ran our finger over those holes, and then the three streams came out individually. And this is something we do often. We kind of choose our own ways, and we don't really want to surrender our wills to Jesus moment by moment, day by day. And we go off on our own ways, and we leave Jesus behind. However, it doesn't have to stay that way, Ashley. We can repent. We can tell Jesus we're sorry. We can invite him back into our lives, and it will happen. And so the Israelites had to learn this too, as they were exiting from Egypt and learning to trust in Jesus and trust in our Heavenly Father. Just a minute. And so that's what merging with Christ is all about. It's surrendering our wills to him, wanting to do his will and not our own. Now, if we'll look at slide 7, the explanation of what you saw. Do you know why that happened, Ashley?
Because we put them together and they want to cling together.
Why would they want to cling together?
Because that's what they want to do.
Okay. Well, in slide 7, you'll read that water molecules are shaped in such a way that one side has a negative charge and the other has a positive charge. The negatively charged side of one molecule attracts the positively charged side of another. And so they merge because they are attracted, Ashley, yes. They kind of like stick together. Slide 8. When you pinch the streams of water together, you bring the molecules from the different streams close enough that they adhere. When you run your finger across the holes, you interrupt this momentarily and the water starts to flow in individual streams. Slide 9, the application. Jesus wants us to walk with him. He wants to walk with us, but not in separate paths. He wants to live within our hearts so that we are abiding in him and walking in his path. If we should backslide and go our own way, we can regain our walk with Jesus through prayer and repentance. Slide 10, Amos 3:3 says, can two walk together except they be agreed? Slide 11 shows a picture of a couple children walking together. Slide 12 shows a couple penguins kind of close there, maybe trying to be together. Slide 13 is another picture of a couple penguins together. And slide 14, two young boys walking down the path, walking together. Now, of course, they can't merge like Jesus can merge with us. But they're close. They're holding hands. Now, we have a bonus for you. It's a treat for the birds. Ashley, I'm wondering if those bird things that we hung out last time have been used. Do you want to run out to the redbud tree and see if they're empty now? And I'm going to move the demonstration part up here, and in our little thing for the birds, yes, on slide 15 is the bonus, and it's the collage that Ashley made for me to my grandma with love, because she knows I enjoy birds. But let's move to slide 16, and I want to give credit. This recipe and idea came from this particular website there at the bottom of the page. HGTV.com design, etc. Now, what you need is some flour, water, The recipe called for corn syrup. I don't have that. I'm going to use peanut butter instead. A package of unflavored gelatin and birdseed. And so in our bowl, I already have the flour added, the unflavored gelatin, and the peanut butter. And we want to just kind of mix that together very quickly because we have a lesson. Turn it this way. And I'm going to ask Ashley, as soon as she checks what we put out last week, to see if it's been eaten. We'll add the water to this and the birdseed really quickly. Can you bring it over here and show us, Ashley? Last Sabbath, we made some bird feeders, special treats, out of a toilet paper roll that we rolled in peanut butter. We smeared peanut butter on it and rolled it in birdseed, and we made about three of those and Ashley hung them in our redbud tree outside.
That's the only one that's left.
This is the only one that's left.
About the other.
And it's empty. So we'll put that to the side. And Ashley, I need a half cup of water. What happened to our jug? Okay, if you will pour that in here using this measurement and get this stirred together. Thank you.
What are we making? We're making,
go ahead and smash it together, dear. Some more treats for the birds. So you get that to smoothed around, and then we're going to, into this mixture, and we want to tip it up so Pastor can get this on there. We're going to add bird seed. And the birdseed is in the bag beside you, and you can just dump most of it in.
Most of it?
Yeah, leave about a half cup out.
All this birdseed?
That's right. We're going to make cookies. This is the dough.
Scoop it out.
Okay, sure. We need about four of those. One.
That means she wants two cups of bird seed.
Three. Well, actually, I want four cups. I forgot that was a half cup measurement. Maybe get this out.
That's four.
Okay, now, Ashley, you can...
You said you want 2 cups.
4 cups. How much more do you need in here?
I just put in 5 cups.
Let's wait and see if this will get all... Let's wait. We may have to use our fingers.
I can do that.
Just add a little bit more water is what I would do. See, this gelatin is going to gel.
There's gelatin in there?
Mm-hmm. Unflavored. And then, would you spray this pan for me, Ashley? We spray it. Pat this out.
What are we spraying it with?
Cooking spray.
Nuts. Stick spray.
You want a picture of it.
Okay. That's enough, sweetheart. Bring it on over. We're on a timetable here. And out it goes. Pour it out. Yes, you may do it. What I want you to do is to pat it out about... Ready?
About what?
About 1 inch thick, so that's thick enough. Make it into one big cookie shape. How's that feel? There's some paper towels I have here somewhere. And now what we're going to do, Ashley. Okay, come back. What we're going to do is use our cookie cutters and cut out some shapes, but these are still kind of fragile, so we lift them up very carefully and put over here on the piece of wax paper. You can do one, and it has to set maybe overnight for the gel to hold it all together. And then once it has set, you tie a string onto it and hang it out. There you go, sweetheart. and the birds will, it will be a treat for them. We'll do one more.
Just one?
Mm-hmm. I know you want to do the rest, but we have to move on to Sabbath school. And while it's there in its shape, we want to make a hole in the middle. This is going to be...
Use the screw that you had earlier.
Where is that screw? Okay, very good idea, Ashley. We make a hole in the middle, so a hole will stay there where we can tie the string into it. Now, we're going to put that aside. This one already. Let it set for a few hours. It's supposed to get hard. Hard enough that you can put twine on it and hang it on a branch outside. So this, will you move this over to another surface, please? This is our bird treat today. But remember, the best lesson that we have is that we want to merge our lives with Jesus. We want to surrender our wills to His will. And then we will know that we are doing what is right, bringing honor to Him, and His angels and His spirit can work with us. So thank you, and I hope you join us next Sabbath for another science demonstration. Bye-bye.